health answers. COVID-19 has led to a rapid change of behaviors, reaffirming the need to understand and apply accurate health information. So we are now spending more time in the world virtually, constantly confronted with false information, making health literacy a growing public health challenge. The World Health Organization defines health literacy as the skill to improve personal and community health by changing personal lifestyle and living conditions. I'm honored to introduce you to Professor Kickbusch, who is worldwide known for her expertise in health promotion and global health. She will today elaborate on health literacy within the times of COVID-19. Professor Kickbusch is a global health consultant with a strong commitment to the empowerment of women. She is also the founding director and chair of the Global Health Center at the Graduate Institute for International and Development Studies in Geneva. Thank you very much, Professor Kickbusch, for joining us today. I'll start with my first question. So how has COVID-19 impacted the health literacy gap? And how can we advocate for clear and accurate information during COVID-19?
Well, good afternoon, Rochelle, and thank you very much for inviting me to discuss health literacy. Of course, during COVID-19, we have seen just how important health literacy is, and particularly how important health literacy is in combination with digital literacy. And I think we'll probably talk a little bit more about that. But I think what we have seen is that a whole lot of our health literacy debate and also our programs have, of course, at least in our part of the world, have been very, very focused on non-communicable diseases. And that many people who were, in quotes, confronted with the coronavirus knew very little about viruses, knew very little about infectious disease, about means of transmission, about many of the things that have become so important in the context of COVID-19. You know, this whole thing about social and physical distancing. And it was also very new for people. So I think also that we saw very clearly that it's not just enough to give information, but that there has to be a discussion about the information. There has to be a debate about the information. The information has to be understandable. And as you rightly says, you know, has to reach people throughout society. So not just the well-educated, and you alluded to the health literacy gap. So of course, people who already have low levels of literacy, low levels of health literacy, and don't have easy access to digital communications are the people who are then left behind. And that's really a warning signal for our health literacy programs.
Which challenges do people with weaker health literacy skills face during this pandemic?
Well, the challenges they face, I think, are manifold. First of all, to literally understand the information that is given. You know, there were some jokes over the last months about everyone's become a virologist or everyone's become an epidemiologist. But what it does say is that some very, very complex concepts were used in trying to convince people about how they should adapt their behaviors. You know, sort of things beginning with R and exponential growth and statistical terms, epidemiological terms, death rates, infection rates. So already here we see that probably when talking about health literacy, we underestimated the other literacies that are important. Science literacy, for example, a certain amount of statistical literacy. You know, what do percentages really mean? What do they mean for me as an individual? And what do they mean for our whole group, our country, or my town, or things like that? So, you know, this making things tangible for people has, I believe, been really, really difficult. And because many people have not been able to understand it. And because they don't have high science literacy, so it means they couldn't understand why is the information changing. You know, 2 months ago they told me this, now they are telling me this. And so this whole issue of trust in health literacy has become much, much more important than I think it was in the past.
So you already mentioned the need of trust, but how can we really build up trust with health literacy during a pandemic?
Well, you build up trust by having a conversation, by being reliable, by being transparent, and by being understandable. Remember, a key element of our discussions in health literacy have been this notion of navigation. You know, how do I navigate information? Which sources are trustworthy? Who can I talk to if I have doubt without being told straight away, you're stupid if you don't accept this or if you don't understand this? Where can I be sure that the information I get is really reliable? Who explains all these things to me? And who is giving the message? I think we have seen that this is becoming very important. Does the head of government give a message? Is there an identifiable person in the public health administration that is regularly, you know, as some people have said, the face of COVID? So it's these kinds of things that have to be built up. If every time I open the television or go on my smartphone and I see another person talking to me about the virus, maybe using different words, different explanations, that makes it very difficult for me if I'm not used to having to deal with complex information and complex decisions, because everything I hear, I have to translate into my everyday life. And one can see, you know, in all these discussions we have, people are constantly asking, well, what does this mean for me? Shall I take my child to school? Can I visit granny? Should I go shopping? When should I wear a mask? People want to translate this into their everyday life. And sometimes the way we have communicated hasn't really taken this seriously. And sometimes we've called people stupid if they ask the same question again and again and again.
So you already mentioned giving clear guidelines which can be implemented in like everyday lives, but how can we give guide people with weaker health literacy skills during this pandemic?
Well, first of all, I think we've been given a truly important signal about neglecting health literacy. And so the gaps that we did not fill before the pandemic, of course, are coming to the fore in the pandemic. And so there's a big catch-up game that we have to play. And that is really worrying. Of course, what we have also seen during the pandemic is that information through digital means, particularly the smartphone, has become more and more important, so that people need to understand that information, how to access it, what does it mean to have a COVID app, what data are really being gathered about me, who knows what I'm doing, are my rights being respected? So, you know, this scope of health literacy has been widened. For me, always, some concepts of health literacy have been too narrow and have focused on information only. It's, you know, it's about decision-making power. It's about trust. It's about being able to deal with new information and really being able to understand that it's not just about me. You mentioned the WHO definition. It's not just about me. It's also about the others. It's about the whole community. So even if what I do doesn't just save me, if I can contribute to community health and I understand what community health is, that makes a big difference. And I think too much of health literacy has been focused only on the individual.
And how can we ensure that people can distinguish between false and accurate information?
Well, there have been a range of approaches already before COVID-19 to offer platforms that are safe and that actually certify information. So, you know, the National Health Service in the United Kingdom has a service where people can check if health information and health apps are reliable. The Austrian health system has built up a system where people can go for certified information. So increasingly, we need that additional effort to be able to tell people, before you believe everything, check here. And that, of course, has also been part of the work of the WHO with many of the big platforms and many of the big tech companies, that when a question is asked on a platform, on a search platform, then the first answer, for example, that comes is an answer from the World Health Organization, or that they warn if an information is not sound. And, you know, there has been much more of that. But of course, there is a general problem because there are groups that question science. There are groups that question vaccination. There are groups that mix scientific information with political intentions. So I think it's a really, really difficult time. And I don't think our public health institutions and our approaches to health literacy were quite prepared how political this would get, and that arguments are not always sufficient to be able to convince people to believe the authorities or to behave differently. So I don't think we have a perfect solution yet. It's definitely not something you can sort out in a week or two. It's really a long-term effort where we have to learn from our failures and our gaps and move forward in a new way.
Thank you very much for your time and all these key insights, elaborating on the need to prepare better to minimize this health literacy gap. We are delighted that you're part of our program.
Thank you very much, Rochelle, for having me. Goodbye.